What it do, everyone? Welcome back to the show. Hope you guys are ready for this. We're going to do a review today about The Idol on HBO. Now, I just watched the first three episodes of The Idol, and I feel so conflicted. Being a man who enjoys BDSM, I thought the show would be for me. I love Hollywood, I love the music industry, so I thought getting a more intimate look on the inside of it, it'd be interesting. Well, they're supposed to be an in-depth look at the dark side of the music industry and lifting Hollywood's curtain. That's what the show wants to tell you that it is, but let me tell you, you quickly understand that it is not. The show is really about manipulation, abuse, and what the price of fame is really going to cost for you. It's supposed to be a turn on idol worshiping, but it comes off as just like creepy ass softcore. The show is about, it has actors, it has a lot of good actors in it, and they don't get as much screen time as I would really hope they would do, because it's pretty much dominated by The Weeknd and Lily. And Lily is doing her thing, okay? She's going all out. She's making me believe this character with Jocelyn. It's like she's acting for a different show, and Jocelyn, her character, embodies that, but her character is torn between all these different things at once. The show, in my opinion, it gets in its own way. You have a part of a show that's about the vultures surrounding Jocelyn, preying on her mental in order to make billions at the cost of her sanity, which in its own right, with these over-the-top, larger-than-life music industry people, it'd be far more compelling if that was the main point. Yet here we are with the show. Instead of focusing on that, we decide to be softcore, indoctrinating, cult like art over anything mentality that's not only disgusting to watch, but it makes all the sex in this show just dirty once you catch on to the creepy grooming from The Weeknd's character Tedris, continuing the cycle of mental abuse that Jocelyn's went through, not fixing anything about Jocelyn's character, actually making things far worse for her. And I don't understand this direction, because then who is this for? You get to go to thinking that who is this show for people like Tedris? And this is only three episodes in. I can't in good faith continue to watch this show seriously. It's a joke. Someone who considers himself as an artist and sees life in the shades of gray, I even found myself cringing in the episodes I've seen so far. I know Samuel Levinson is all about being edgy, yet this show is so cringy it's hard to watch at times. Like it's funny at one time, try to be emotional at another time. Then being a cringy softcore porn and all in the same episode. The actors do look like they're having fun and making the most of the show. Yet as a viewer, I don't know what I'm supposed to feel. Tedris is a loser who found other losers that believe in him, yet at the same time he's a genius who played this long con, giving Jocelyn's backup dancer Diane her song and music video in all this turn. Like, how am I supposed to believe the guy who slaps the nutritionist in the face, then has to jerk off in a corner of a Balenciaga, is also a guy who's manipulated this woman's, Jocelyn's life behind the scenes for a year with Diane, putting her in a position to take over Jocelyn's spot at her record label? And what happened to the Diane story? Like, one moment Diane is, oh, we're gonna go to a club, boom, she introduces her to Tedris. The next moment, oh, Diane's a great dancer, oh, let's get her in the studio immediately, and boom, barely see her, and you find out she's sleeping with Tedris. Well, she just shows up. Yeah, oh yeah, she's not better late than me or some shit. Like, it's so weird. Like, dude, it's a fucking joke. Which hurts the show so much. Lily has put this show on her shoulders right now. She's pulling the best out of every freaking scene she's on the show. And I think that's really dope for Lily. I think that's really dope for Lily. After the show, she's going to have such a great career. But if she's not naked, she's crying. And if she's not crying, she's being abused. She's being emotionally abused by every other character in the show. And then they get into this whole point where they want to get into the BDSM, the sexual aspect of it, and how it ties to her mental psyche. And at first, you see that she wants these things. She wants to be choked. She wants to be groped. But she just wants to be loved. But Tedris, this character, this wannabe fucking... Oh, man. Don't get me started on this guy. This wannabe Ike Turner, it's using this against her. You go to find out that all this stems from her mother's passing, which was something in this show that they threw a curveball immediately in three episodes. Her mother was supposed to be the one who motivated her. Her mother was supposed to be the one who pushed her. And when her mother passed, it broke her spirit. And now you go to find out it's because her mother was fucking abusing the living hell out of her. And she's a victim of abuse. She's so used to abuse. Her whole entire life has been that way. And this guy, Tetris, I don't know if he was tipped off to this or what, or he just knew, because that's just all the people he surrounded himself with. And he just continues his abuse and continues taking control of her life. And no one's there to help her. That's another thing I don't get. No one's there to help her. No one's there to help Jocelyn. People that's been in her whole entire life. People claim that care about her. People that claim that they've been there for her. No one's there to help her. And in episode 3 is just like the epitome of just like, if you're going to continue watching the show or not, which I had to realize, like, yo, this show is trying to be hardcore, but it's coming off as like just really cringy, really exploitationist, really sexist, like just really fucked up in all kind of rights. And it could be because it lost its original director 80% away of the film, the show's actually being completely finished. It could be because she stepped down for some reason. Rolling Stone reported as because The Weeknd said that the show had too much of a feminist direction and Sam stepped in. It could be because of that, but like, it's just not working. So if you take the show serious, you're definitely going to hate it. And reviews reflect. It has a 25% on Rotten Tomato for a critical review and a 58% of an audience review. Like, look, this show, it's not something I would refer to anybody. In all actuality, it's not good. But it's not necessarily bad. It's really mediocre. You know what I mean? But it's triggering, and that I think is something that needs to be the real conversation behind it. It's triggering. Does it need to even be triggering? Like, art is subjective. Art comes in all forms. But does this need to be triggering? Do we need to see a character like this on the main stage in 2023? Who is this helping? Is this helping other young women stay away from a man like this? Or is this empowering young men who want to be men like this? Like, I don't see a benefit from this show from anybody in the audience, and that's where I stand. So watch this at your own risk. The Idol is honestly the worst show of this year. Take that in mind. It's my opinion. You can take it how you want to take it, and that's just how I feel about my review. If you ain't going to watch it, watch it. If you're not going to watch it, don't watch it. So, those are my thoughts on The Idol. Thanks for watching. Catch you next time. Peace.